Hey babies, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. Now's a good time to go ahead and subscribe. Today's video is actually in partnership with Darling USA. So this is a fairly new company. Of course, all the details will be listed down in my description box below. And today I'm going to be showing you how to do some at-home beginner-friendly feed and braid. So these are just some of the items that of course came along with the package just to better assist with the style. I'll be sure to link everything down below so that you guys can pick it up. This is actually my first time using this hair. It is a synthetic fiber, which I was a little bit apprehensive about at first, of course, because typically we like to use human hair whenever it is we do any type of braiding styles. But you guys, this hair was extremely soft. It was not tangling at all. You guys can see exactly what this looks like. Already have my hair pretty much blow dried out. You guys know when you do feed in braids, you definitely want to go ahead and section off the hair ahead of time. That way it's a smoother process. You guys, I'm only going to be doing about 6 feed in braids here. And so I've already pre-sectioned off the braiding hair, of course, into smaller sections, no larger than about 1/4 inch. And so I did that for about 2 of the bundles. So I did have 1 additional bundle left over. You guys can see it comes with 3, and that was literally completed with 1 pack of hair. So that should give you an idea of how much hair actually comes into the package, which I appreciate. And now I'm going to go ahead and just get started with the actual braiding. So, of course, I did go ahead and section off my hair, and I'm taking that olive oil edge control just to give my hair something to adhere to. You do want the style to last and be extremely smooth, and so this definitely will help out. Obviously, you can use whatever edge control you guys are familiar and comfortable with. There's no pressure here. And then I'm actually in love with this comb. I've seen this a million times with other YouTubers, and I finally have one myself. It definitely helps with the braiding process, just sectioning everything out, because of course it is that ragtail comb. So that metal tip helps you go through the hair very easily. And then on the tips of my hair, I'm actually just applying a little bit of that edge control as well, just to better lay everything down, because you guys know my hair is not pressed out. It's literally just shampooed, washed, conditioned, all that stuff, blow dried out, so it can still be a bit frizzy. Now at the start of the braid, I'm literally just going to start to cornrow my hair as normal. Once I braid it down, maybe about 3, probably about 3 strands, I did go ahead and add a little bit of that hair. You guys will notice that throughout this video, I do actually add in about 4 to 5 sections to each of my braids. And that's just because my hair swells. So my hair is really thick. And when I go ahead and braid it, I don't really care for the braids that are sitting really high off of the scalp. I like for everything to look as natural as possible. And so you guys can see how this hair is extremely soft. It's not tangling at all. And I know typically that is the stigma when it comes to synthetic hair, which is why I typically never use it. So far so good. I was actually extremely happy with what this looked like. I got very little shedding when it came to actually adding the hair to my own. Honestly, all of it kind of maintained its structure the entire time. The hair was super duper light, and you guys can see I'm wearing the color 1B. It looks extremely close to my texture. And once you guys get to the end of this video and you kind of get that full overview, you'll see how the luster does not compromise my luster, because y'all know I'm a 4BC EFG type of girl. And so finding braiding hair that is going to match your texture is critical, because of course you don't want any of your natural hair peeking through, and you can clearly tell the difference. So I definitely appreciated that. Like I said, you can actually pick up this hair in your local Walmart. If not, there is also a link that I will be sure to post down into my description box below, of course. And so from here, I pretty much, I think on this braid, I did use about 5 strands, if I'm not mistaken. And then throughout the rest of my hair, I ended up using 4 strands to add in. And you guys will see once we're completed with everything, how the braids are extremely flat and smooth. So y'all, I'm here for it. And you guys know this is only my 2nd time doing the feed in cornrows on my channel, so I just wanted to kind of do an updated one just to see the progress. And you know, doing feed in braids is a little bit more complicated when you're doing it on yourself versus doing it with someone else. So if you have to run this video back a few times, do not hesitate to do so, just because it is a kind of, it's like a learning process, right? You have to wrap your mind around the fact that you are slowly adding hair and you cannot do it all at once, because it will cause your hair to kind of buckle and honestly, you won't be able to move through it. So I definitely appreciated the, I guess, the hair, honestly, because I thought it was going to be a lot more, a lot more harder to work with than it ended up being. And if you guys did not notice, I didn't even have to pull apart the ends. So it already came pre-stretched. The hair was super long. And so I definitely appreciated that because I didn't have to worry about adding in so much more hair because the length was there from root to tip. And by the end of this, you guys will see that the braids came all the way down to my butte, okay? And I am 5'2", so I hope that helps. So I'm just gonna go ahead and continue finishing up these braids. Of course, if you want to just stick around for some nice tunes, definitely do that. If you are a beginner, definitely make sure to play this back as many times as you have to. I did not speed up this video too much because I want you guys to see how I'm literally splitting off my third leg of my braid, placing the additional synthetic fiber hair right underneath where I'm braiding, and then I'm slowly adding everything in. So I know it's been like 4 years now. I've been telling you guys I'm gonna do a cornrow tutorial, but I don't really know how to explain the way that I do it because you guys see I hold my fingers in kind of a weird way. So if you want to braid underhanded, the process may be a little bit different, but nevertheless, you see what's going on. Play it back. I am a visual learner, so I hope this helps anybody that is in that same situation with me. And of course, you could do the braids as small as you need to. There's no pressure to do the 6 braids. Originally, I wanted to do the 8, but just based off of the hair, I'm like, let's see how this is going to work out the thicker that I make it. So anyway, I'm done talking. I'll see you guys once we are wrapping up so that I can show you how to secure the braids down to the nape of your neck and also set the style. So be back soon. right, babe. So you guys can see we are finishing up the braids now. You guys, I am so proud of this hair. First of all, the price point is freaking amazing. And I'm also really shocked. I keep saying this, but I'm so shocked because it's synthetic hair and it does not look like it at all. You guys can see it's matching my luster of my hair. You can't tell where it begins, where it ends. No, I can tell where that braid on the right needed a little bit more tender love and care, but that's okay. That is okay. For the sake of this video, we're gonna go ahead and actually take a little bit of that needle and thread. You can actually use the cotton thread. You don't have to use the nylon one. And go ahead and secure the braids. You guys can see I did go right up underneath the nape of my area, or the nape of my neck area, to go ahead and pull the thread through. That way the braids sit close together. You don't have to worry about there being any separation in the back. And if you're not super experienced with this, you guys can see I'm not doing any fancy loops. I'm literally just going underneath my braid, pulling the strand through, and then at the very end, the only step you will need to do is go ahead and pull that under the last braid, preferably the middle braid, wrap it around your needle three times, pull, bam, cut it off, and you're good. You guys can see how flat it caused my braids to lay. Y'all, I was super happy with this protective style. I should have actually been doing this since last year just because it's super easy and convenient. So did go ahead and take some boiling hot water, put it in the microwave. Take your favorite mousse. Of course, I'm using the one that Darling did send me because why not? And I'm just gonna go ahead and put that all over. Now, in another one of my braided videos, you guys are like, why'd you put so much mousse? You really wanna make sure that the style is set. And if you are using a really good mousse, you should not have any flakiness, nothing like that. It should literally set the style. You'll take a blow dryer, heat it up just to go ahead and quickly kind of set everything. Go ahead and dip your braids. Put a little bit of that mousse on the braids as well, just in case you have any frizziness there. But in this case, you guys can see this hair was smooth all the way down from root to tip. The ends were perfectly blended and feathered out, so I appreciated that I did not have to do any additional work. Who does not love that? And you guys can see the braids are beautifully shiny, nice, soft, textured, and boom, we're pretty much set. Now, it did take a little bit of extra work to get the braids completely dry, just because obviously it is synthetic hair, so it's not gonna dry the same. Took me about maybe 10 minutes with the blow dryer just to make sure that everything was completely dry. Gonna go ahead and take the oil serum just to go all throughout my hair. There was also a braiding spray included, but I decided to go ahead and take a little bit of hairspray just to make sure there were absolutely no flyaways, and boom, voila. It is definitely a look. So given where we started versus where we are now, you guys, I'm completely satisfied with this look. Leave any comments or questions down below. I love you guys so much. Stay pretty, and I will see you next time.